Former crime reporter Ace Atkins does it again. His latest Quinn Colson novel is hot off the press just months after his release. His latest Spencer novel for the Robert B. Parker estate.
Man is always writing. I wonder if his fingers still are there. The Sinners deals with everything from the drug trade to the black market, all in rural Mississippi, where we kind of have this notion that we can leave our doors unlocked, that there's no crime, that life is great. It's not always the case.
Not always. I mean, as you guys know from reporting the news every day, even though we live in the Mid-South and in, you know, in the hub of Southern society, things can get a little dicey sometimes.
Life is slow, but sometimes the criminals are one step ahead.
That's right.
Why rural Mississippi this time?
Well, you know, the Quinn Colson books are set in North Mississippi and occasionally in Memphis. I love writing about the Mid-South. I love this area. I love the people. I love the culture. Mm-hmm. I like writing about my own backyard. And there's plenty of action here, whether we want it or not. I know I'm going
to
break it to you, but there's a little bit of criminal activity going on here.
Really?
Yeah, I know. I'm shocked. I know you guys are shocked. Yeah.
So we've talked before about Lily Virgil, who is Quinn's, she was Quinn's deputy. Did you intentionally move her to Memphis to be a U.S. Marshal in this book so that you could bring more Memphis in? Because some of the other Quinn books have spent some time in Memphis, but this one is, you know, there's a bit more.
There's always a part in the books where I feel like the action picks up a little bit, and it's always when it happens in Memphis. And so, yes, I took Lily Virgil out of North Mississippi, and I gave her a broader job to do something, to work for the U.S. Marshal Service in Memphis, because I wanted to come back and do more stories in Memphis.
Well,
so
like
at some
that.
Point, maybe she'll have her own series, something to do, but I think she'd be a good Memphis hero for
I love
sure.
Lily.
How do these, so many of your fans want to know, how do these characters develop? Where do they come from?
Craziness. Where do the characters come from? They come from people I know. You know, you talk about Lily Virgil. I mean, everyone comes from all different kind of places and influences. But, you know, we were talking the other day about Lily Virgil. And when I used to be a newspaper reporter, I used to cover a lot of great women that worked in law enforcement. Mm. And sometimes they don't get the credit that they deserve. And I met some just fantastic, tough-as-nails women working in law enforcement. And so she's a tribute to some of those women that I covered and I wrote about.
I love it. So Quinn is also getting married in this book. Your characters have a lot of layers. Even the bad characters have some, like Fanny. I mean, she's...
Yes.
What, madam, I guess you would call her.
She owns a legitimate gentleman's club. She owns a legitimate club where there is exotic dancing going on and maybe a little bit of illicit activity, you know, but Fanny, she's another tough character, just on the other side of, Lily works on one side of the law, Fanny works on the other
but
side.
But you don't hate Fanny. I mean, your characters have a lot of layers. I like Fanny.
I like Fanny, too. I mean, I wouldn't trust her. I wouldn't want to do business with Fanny Hathcock. I mean, she is a mean, spiteful person. But is she smart? Is she capable? Is she good at her job? Absolutely.
When you finish a project like this, what thoughts kind of go through your head?
When I finish a project like this, the first thought that goes through my head is, I got to do this again. I got to start over. It's time. And right when a book is out, book just came out yesterday. Yeah. I'm starting on a national tour. When I leave Memphis, I'll be gone for 2 weeks, traveling across the country, talking about the Mid-South, talking about Memphis.
We like that.
Yeah, absolutely. Maybe not the part that, you know, I'm not going to be invited to some Chamber of Commerce meetings. But when I get back, it's always time to start back to work.
Mm. There's always a deadline.
Even though this book is freshly out, it's time to work on the next one.
We're glad to have you back here.
So some more criminal activity, let me know. I'll keep on watching, get some more ideas. So
thanks
to you guys.
His Memphis arm of his tour kicks off tonight at Novel at 6.